Hey everybody, this is Jonathan with Pioneer Cycle Sports, and in this video we're going to show you just how easy it is to install Pioneer's left side power meter crank arm with an Amp Plus device like this Garmin Edge 520. Pioneer's single leg power meter is a great way to get into training with power. The crank arms come in both Durace 9000 and Ultegra 6800. And in Durace, they're available in lengths from 165 all the way up to 180 millimeters. For the Ultegra, you can get lengths 165, 170, 172.5, and 175 millimeters. Right out of the box, the sensor is set up for Amp Plus single leg mode, so it's ready to give you total power on your Garmin computer. To confirm that the crank is set up in Amp Plus single leg mode, remove the battery and replace it. You should see the orange LED blink 10 times. Now, before going any further, we recommend that you check to be sure the Garmin's computer has Garmin's latest firmware. Now, from your Garmin Cycle computer, we're going to pair the sensor as you would any other Amp Plus device. In the Garmin 520's case, scroll down to Menu, scroll down to Settings and press Enter, scroll down to Sensors and press Enter, enter Add Sensor, scroll down to Power and press Enter. The Garmin will prompt you to spin the crank to ensure the sensor is awake. We recommend 3 rotations at about 60 RPM. Either direction is fine. Once the sensor is found, the power meter will be displayed with the ID listed. Be sure the Pioneer's Amp Plus ID is checked and press Enter. Your Pioneer power meter is now paired with the Cycle computer. Finally, you'll want to be sure to zero calibrate the sensor before you ride. Again, Menu,
Settings,
Sensors, select your power meter, scroll down to calibrate and press Enter. You'll see calibration successful when done. You're ready to roll. Now the power meter does provide cadence using the built-in accelerometers, but for the highest precision you can use the included magnets. And to do that, we're going to install them using our magnet placement template. Locate the proper magnet position by placing the template on the crank spindle and then temporarily tape the magnet on the frame. Now install the crank arm, gently give it a spin and check that the sensor clears the chainstay and the magnet. You'll want to be sure that the sensor is no more than 10 millimeters from the magnet when it passes. If the chainstay doesn't provide enough clearance, you can place the magnet on the down tube or the seat tube. To ensure you have proper magnet distance, remove and replace the battery, rotate the crank forward at about 30 RPM. You'll see a green confirmation light indicating that the sensors and magnet are in close enough proximity. Permanently attach the magnet and you're ready to go. And don't forget, for the ultimate in power meter accuracy, Pioneer offers a way to upgrade to a dual leg system with their right side upgrade kit. Send them your drive side crank and they'll install sensors and ship it back to you. Once you get your crank back, simply install it back on your bike. For pairing, we're gonna wanna switch both sensors to dual leg Amp Plus mode. To do this, remove and replace both batteries. Both sensors will flash orange for roughly 10 seconds, and while the LEDs are flashing, press the mode switch button for 3 seconds and release. This will switch both sensors into dual leg mode and Amp Plus balance metrics will now be available. Thanks for watching, I'm Jonathan, and if you're looking for the video on how to set this up for a Pioneer computer, click right here. Subscribe to our channel for more updates, and remember, knowledge is power, and power is king.